What's up, NASCAR 15 fans? David Land here, coming to you from the most unique racetrack in the entire world, Kansas Speedway. We are here to do the third race of my second return to NASCAR 15. And of course, I have to thank all of you guys in the comments section. Watching this video right now, the race at Texas was the second video in the return to NASCAR 15. They got 200 likes, so thank you guys so much for that. Be sure to hit the like button on this one. Let's see if we can do 200 likes again. And remember, if you go down in the comments and leave a suggestion of a track you'd like me to go to for next week's NASCAR 15 video, hopefully those will each be going out every week now on Wednesday, but leave a track suggestion down there and you may get a shout out in the next video if I decide to use your track. So let's get qualified here at Kansas. I'm running at night. I don't think I've run the night version of Kansas in NASCAR 15. We're second right now behind Casey Kane. See if we can pick up the pace here. I've got the Michigan setup on it. I think that I've decided that this is kind of my default setup for the banked tracks. Seems to be really, really fast, and right now I'm picking up speed here on my previous best lap, so just got to get around this track one more time, and I think after this lap I'll simulate the rest of qualifying, because I feel like I don't want to waste my tires for the run at the end. So real quick, folks, today's video is going to be a little bit different. I had some problems with the recording of this video. The audio recorded, but the rest of the race did not. So I recorded the replay of the race and played my live audio over it. It may be a new style of video, so don't dislike it too much. This is kind of a video that was saved in editing, but the race was so fun that I decided to put it up anyway. So if you do enjoy it, still leave a like on it. If you don't, you don't. Next week's video will hopefully be technical issues. Issue free. But anyway, enjoy a TV style NASCAR 15. All right, Kansas Speedway starting from the pole, ready to go here. 42 drivers in the rear view mirror, Clint Bowyer to the outside. The race is about to begin, and it goes, and I got wheel spin. Darn. Well, that lead lasted about that far. Shouldn't they give Clint Bowyer a penalty for making it to the line before the pole sitter? Isn't that a rule? But anyway, let's get going here. Ooh, the front end is gripping very well. And they're three wide behind us. I had to block Biffle down to the inside. Clint Bowyer still leads. Here comes Dale Earnhardt Jr. all the way to the outside. He's going to pull around into the lead. And we're going to split the difference between both Earnhardt and Bowyer. And Earnhardt nearly spins me out. Oh my gosh. How on earth did that not cause an absolutely enormous wreck? Now we're side by side with Casey Kane into turn number one, right on the apron, up into Casey Kane. Casey Kane gets up into the wall, now we're sliding, now we're spinning, and we're damaged, and there's a big old crash. Darn it. Well, we're not completely last. Michael Annett was slower in the pits than we were, so we're going to restart more than or less dead last. And we're racing again at Kansas. Time to come up through the traffic. This will be a good exercise, I suppose. And we're already up 10 positions. And we're moving up pretty steadily through the field already. That's awesome. So now I'm going to be a bit cautious. I wasn't very cautious on the start because I kind of wanted to race hard and take the lead and run away, but apparently that was not in the cards. We're going to need Cole Witt and Matt Kenseth, and are we wrecking? We were very nearly wrecking there. That was Austin Dillon in the Cheerios car, very nearly causing a massive pileup. We raced hard with him at Texas. Of course, NASCAR tried to rig it for him, and did not work out for them. Where was your debris caution, NASCAR? Three wide with Truex and Yaley. As Yaley drives around the outside, that car showing a lot of pace, the old Dr. Pepper machine. Very close with J.J. Yaley. He decided to bail out of it. All right. So let's go into Eric Almirola here. Well, he's going to block to the inside, so we'll just use the cheater line down there. drive around him as well. We're already up into the top 20 after just a couple laps. Somebody's going very slow through the center. It looks like maybe Jeff Gordon in the 3M car. Tony Stewart's getting thrown into the wall by a red car. It might be Casey Kane. Can't tell for sure yet. It was Kane. And let's go around Logano here. Nope, on the inside, middle. Wow. All right, three more positions there as we just drive through the field with the greatest of ease. It might be a little bit harder once we get back up to Bowyer, who leads the race still. In fact, all the Michael Waltrip cars are up here. Michael Waltrip in his own car is up here, running 11th right now as we bang off of Kevin Harvick, who finally decided to show his face in one of these races. We'll run the Kyle Larson line a bit with Tony Stewart. Now we'll go underneath and try to get underneath Jeff Gordon and Michael Waltrip. Three wide. We're still three wide. And into turn number one, we get them both. And the car washes out a little bit because I took way too shallow of an entry into turn number one. But I got around them all and don't have to worry about that. So let's try to break into the top 10 here. Try to go around the outside of Brian Vickers, or we'll split the difference between Vickers and Biffle. Okay. And side by side we go. Bye bye, Vickers. And decidedly, the racing gets a little tougher as we get up here. So we've got to race with cars that are a little bit faster than potentially we are. But right now, we're not having too much trouble. Keselowski is up there looking to the inside of Busch. And it looks like Jimmy Johnson moved up to P2 here as we go on to Trevor Bayne. Brad Keselowski. Try to get around him as well to the outside. And yes, that works. The outside lane working really well for me right now. We go around Kyle Busch as well. And suck up behind Dale Jr. in the draft here. And pull around both of them. Wow, with the greatest of ease, just driving around some of these guys. Fantastic. So now, Jimmy the Juggernaut and Clinton Bowyer with that MWR power, which is just seems to be going very well right now. Lift off the gas, get a little bit of brake in there, pull around, and a pretty good corner there. Gang on our best lap. We were 700ths up, which is a lot of time to gain when you're talking NASCAR lap times. You can run so consistently here. Really good turn three. Gained a 10th as we use the cheater line, try to get a really good lap there. Ooh, fastest lap of the race. Right on par with our qualifying times as well. Very, very nice. And right behind Jimmy Johnson, we'll get in his draft a little bit. Don't have to push too hard, obviously. A lot of the race to go, almost 40 laps. So let's again pull behind Jimmy Johnson here and pull around him on the outside. Can we do it? He's in the draft of Bowyer to the inside. Side by side and pull around Jimmy Johnson. Now let's close in on Clint Bowyer. We've gone from 42nd to second. Can we go back to first, our rightful place? The tire wear is pretty extreme here, I'm noticing on the on at least my tires. It'll be interesting to see when everybody else has to pit. Obviously, I came in after the wreck, so I needed, or I have probably an extra lap or two in hand. So that's very good. And yeah, exactly 40 to go now. So whenever I said there's 40 laps to go, I really meant there's over 40 laps to go. And Clint is being a little bit difficult. We'll slide underneath and try to get around him. Oh yeah, you can do that in NASCAR 15. I kind of forgot. And Bowyer is already pitting. So yeah, there's already a ton of cars in the pits, actually. And Bowyer and Johnson coming into the pits. So who will take over P2? It's Dale Jr., it looks like. He stays out. Of course, I got a lot longer that I can stay out. We may win this race on strategy by a long way now that we pinned it under that first yellow. Of course, my front end's not looking terribly great, but apparently the aerodynamics are still fine because we're still getting some really good grip here in the corners, as we're probably going to be right mired in the middle of lap traffic, and lap traffic with better tires than us. So this will be a little bit interesting here as we come around complete lap number 16. And Tony Stewart is P2 right now. I don't know if he's in the pits. There's still a few cars staying out with me on the track, but we are 8 seconds ahead of Tony, which is pretty remarkable considering we were battling with him earlier, and he wasn't too far back off the leaders. So pretty crazy that we've got such a big lead right now. And now we're absolutely mired in traffic as many, many cars are coming out of the pits here. And I can still make it a couple more laps on the fuel and tires. I'm liking how this is going so far as we pull out ahead of a lot of the front row motorsports cars, and a Stewart Haas car was in there. And lift off the gas. I can do fuel saving. I'm 22 seconds ahead of Stewart now because Stewart is coming to the pit. Oh, and we get to pit under the yellow, crash up in front. Yeah, literally all the cars got a wave around. So nobody's a lap down. Yay, just what Brian France wanted. So let's go back to the green here with Tony Stewart on the outside. After he benefited from my pit strategy as well, green is out. Ooh, spun the tires. I should have probably chosen the outside lane. I'll have to remind myself of that for the next restart if there is one. And I am leading here at Kansas. I'm third place now with Logano looking to the inside. We're going to go three wide for the lead with Stewart and Logano. This could get ugly going into turn three. Recky Stenhouse looking behind. Tony Stewart still on the outside, still trying to swing around. They're still side by side with him, and Smoke takes the lead. He holds on to the lead for another lap. Now Tony's coming to play. He looks like he's going to be the big challenger here as we go into turn three. Really drove it in deep there. But it stays underneath me, and I pull around Stewart. Now Stenhouse moves up into P2. Looking to the inside is Recky. And he bailed out of it, so now we can possibly pull away here. Let's see. Again, we're going to have better fuel mileage than the majority of the guys who stayed out, got wave rounds, whatever. So we may actually be able to lap some cars finally. I've been clear for a while there, Spotter. But thanks for reminding me. I appreciate it. And they are really racing hard in the middle of the pack. So assuming that Paul Menard doesn't decide to drive out in the middle of traffic again, we should be pretty good. And let's see, 6 tenths ahead of Stenhouse and Gainey. This is going as well as you could possibly hope right now. Yeah, thank you, Spotter. I love it when the Spotter gushes over how good you're doing. It's like, yay, I'm doing good. I'm doing good at NASCAR 15. Now, if only I could maintain the success in NASCAR Heat Evolution. Wouldn't that be nice? But we are rolling off into turn number three. Let's see if we can set some good fast laps here and start to lap some guys. That might be a little bit of fun. It's actually kind of fun driving through the middle of the field, or driving from the back to the front. It's exciting. Oh, fastest lap of the race right there. Two hundredths up on my last best lap of the race. Now it looks like I'm going even faster on this lap. It was a tenth up for just a split second there on the back straightaway. See if we can't improve a little bit more. Drive around the outside. Try to keep that throttle in. That was really... Wow. Okay. Yeah, I don't think I could do that all day. I do not think I could do that all day. That was way closer than it needed to be, to me just completely throwing the race away, trying to run that Kyle Larson line. Goodness gracious me. That was a little closer than I wanted to make that. I thought that was an ill-advised move by me. That was too crazy. Too crazy. Oh, I think I may run my fastest lap this time. Let's see if we can do it. Right down the bottom. Yes! Fastest lap of the race. We're keeping at it, keeping it going. Let's see if we can run another really fast lap here. No, it's not going to happen this time. But how's our fuel doing? We're about half a tank. So I'm guessing some cars are about to come into the pits already. It seems always to be the case as we move around the center of the corner and down onto the apron, across the line. And I'm digging hard, trying to anyway. No, that's a tenth off. Yep, just as I say it, a car coming into the pit. So we are 3 seconds ahead of the competition at the moment, which is pretty awesome if I do say so myself. It's always good to have a 3 second lead on 100% your own pace as I pass whoever that is in the pits and lap them at least once. Hopefully I'll lap them twice. Pull through turn number 1 and 2. I almost called it 3 and 4. What am I thinking? What are you talking about, David? Down the back straightaway as we have more cars peeling off into the pits, and we're probably going to have some serious traffic to deal with. Hopefully this time no yellows come out, so we can have some clean racing and some clean lap traffic to deal with. I do like driving through lap traffic. It's fun. And as the spotter says, I'm having fun out there. Yes, I am. Yes, I am, spotter. You know me so well. You know me so well. All right, so we are coming up behind. Is this Josh Wise? We haven't seen him all day. If I identified that car from that far back, I am a genius. I don't think I'm a genius, though, because that is not Josh Wise, I'm pretty sure. Who is it, though? I don't know. I don't know if we're going to actually be able to catch him. Oh, well. We are lapping a lot of guys coming out of the pits, though. It looks like Michael McDowell, who is the car directly ahead of us. And we go around. Oh, no, we don't. No, we don't. Did that bring out a yellow? No, it didn't. Thank goodness. I wanted a green flag run, and I almost ruined it. I keep forgetting that they will get out of your way, kind of, if they're coming out of the pits. Now Michael Waltrip helped me draft around Danica there. And on the brakes. Oh, car is sliding up. And off through the corner. Down the back straightaway again. As most of the field is in the pits now. And there's the yellow. This time I remembered to choose the outside lane. Hopefully we get a better restart. We're coming down here leading the race from Ricky Stenhouse. Race is ready to get back underway, and we're green, and Stenhouse still got a better restart than I did, but I think I should be able to pull around the outside of him. Stewart back to the inside. I think we lose 2 positions to Stewart and Stenhouse here on the restart. We are just Chase Elliott-ing these restarts so bad. These are some bad restarts. They're almost in the Jeff Gordon realm, and that's really bad. But I guess Bobby Labonte's a lap down. He was 38th there. Oh, we're going to split the difference between Logano and Stenhouse, and there's the speed. There is the speed as we go around Stewart as well. And we did pass Stewart there. Excellente. And now off we go to the races. Or maybe we're at the race. We're at the races, but we're going off to another one because we're going so fast. I don't know. I'm 2 tenths up on my fastest lap. I've run all race long. 3 tenths now. Almost 4 tenths. And it's gone. Maybe I'm still going to be up on this lap despite the fact that I ran into the wall. Yep. All right, let's try to run faster this time by. Even though it's going to be... it's 2 tenths off this time. Of course, I lost all that momentum. I lost all that momentum trying to run the fastest lap of the race. Oh, well. Maybe I can run one this time. I love taking advantage of the fresh tires and just absolutely mollywopping the competition. It's always fun to do that. So let's see. We'll run the cheetah line, across the line, and into turn 1. Get this thing nailed down to the bottom. Did I get on the throttle too soon or too late? No, just about right. I'm still 10th off. See if we can do better in 3 and 4 this time. Lift off. Try to run that line. Yeah, right down to the bottom. No, still half a second off my best lap. Well, I guess you have 1 lap on these tires to really make a difference, and it didn't make it happen on that time by. Yeah, lift, 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 right down to the bottom on the throttle. Car washes up the banking a bit. Okay, maybe we've got something to work with on this lap in terms of lap time. Lift, lift, no. Once again, nothing to work with. And right back off the corner and slowing again. Are we going to be able to make it to the end on fuel? And I don't think we will. So I'm a little bit worried now as I run into the wall. May have to make a splash and dash here at the end of the race, which could be problems and implications because of the obvious reasons of, oh crap, you know. If I have to make a stop with three to go and potentially lose the lead or something, that could be some real issues. We're just going to have to see. I mean, everybody's pretty much on the same pit strategy as me as far as I'm aware. There may be some guys who need to pit really early here during the stint. Just don't know. What I could do is pit early and then, you know, hope that nobody crashes in the pits and traps me a lap down. That could be really bad. No, I'm just going to stay out. There's no reason. If I lose the race on strategy, I lose the race on strategy. The only thing I can do is run a fast pace, and if that pace is not fast enough to win the race, it's not fast enough to win the race. If I lose it because cars are crashing in the pits, there's nothing I can do about that fact. So, it's whatever. So we've got 12 laps to go here, more or less. I think it may be 13 or whatever, depending on how this game counts laps. I don't really know. I'll just wait till the spotter says 10 to go, and then I'll know, which will probably be either in the next lap or the lap after that. So that's exciting commentary. That's really good commentary. Let's see. What else? I don't think NASCAR even runs. Do they seriously run Kansas twice a year? I honestly can't remember. I think they don't. I think they used to. Is this game really that far out of date that Kansas has two dates or just has a day and a night time? That is something NASCAR Heat should also consider doing for their sequel, is even tracks that don't run at night anymore, don't have two dates, give us the night time of the track anyway. And maybe in career mode, there may be like a rain delay or something, and you have to run the race on a Monday in like dreary conditions or something. That'd be kind of cool. That would be kind of cool. But of course it'll never happen, because it would actually be kind of cool. They might have to develop a little something new or something. That was bad. That was bad. That was really bad. I am interested to see if they do anything different with the next NASCAR Heat game. Like, I'm fully expecting it to be just the same thing with the new paint schemes from 2017. I'm not expecting it to be any different. I'll be shocked. Yeah, I'm having fun. I'll be shocked if it actually has different things. Or if they actually listened to what the fans actually want. Which seems to be more of a simulation than an arcade game. I know some people like the replays in NASCAR 15 when the crashes happen. Honestly, I don't mind that so much, but I do wish you could run the yellow laps. I hate the fact that in NASCAR Heat, they make you skip the yellow laps. They don't let you drive under caution. They don't let you pit under caution. The game does it all for you. I don't think that's very good. I don't think that's very fun, in my opinion. If they're going to go with some sim elements, I think you need to be able to turn it into a sim if you want it to be. And that's the problem with NASCAR Heat, is like, it's like they took a bunch of elements from Sims. They took the bad elements from Sims and the bad elements from arcade games, and they put them both in the game. And they didn't really put any of the good things from arcade games or Sim games in. It's really a weird combination that NASCAR Heat decided to go with. So, the spotter's mad about the tires, and literally the front right is completely gone. But we'll come in the next time by, because I'm expecting there will be some shenanigans. Ooh, the spotter is getting very forceful. Yes, sir. There's Paul Menard. He made it out of the pits without crashing. Alright, so I'm coming in. See if we can actually make it in without wrecking. And looks like we're doing well. Don't speed. Do not speed. Do not speed. Do not speed. There we go. Perfect. Alright, I'm just doing right side tires and a splash of fuel. That's probably all I'll need to get to the end of this thing. Let's do it. 8 seconds in the pits. And out we go. And we're 50 seconds ahead of Tony Stewart, so no need to worry about it too much as we run the curbs here at the Kansas City. What am I talking about? Kansas City Speedway. Kansas Speedway road course. But we're back out of the pits. Tony is now 7-8 seconds behind. And essentially 4 laps to go. And we should be pretty good here to the end. Why did a splash of fuel fill the car? I'll never understand that. So into turn number one, and around the outside we go, down the back straightaway, and things are going pretty well here. With we're going to come to 3 laps to go this time by. Probably won't be able to lap anybody, unfortunately, but we did get the green flag run I was hoping for. Now, let me just say, if there's a wreck now, I am screwed. I am... Oh, don't say that, spotter. I'm afraid he's jinxing it. I'm really afraid he's jinxing it. Because if any shenanigans happen, I'm in big trouble. I gotta get to that white flag. That's my saving grace. That's the thing that's gonna keep me in the lead and keep me in a victory position here as we make it around turn number four, getting the 2-to-go signal from the stand. And now it's just the tense moment of potential victory or potential defeat. What is it gonna be? Down the back straightaway, hoping everybody keeps it sane here as I make it through turn three and four. Through turn four, here we come. The white flag is coming out, and no yellow. Here we go. A victory potentially in the making at the most interesting and unique track in the world, Kansas Speedway, off of turn number two, down the back straightaway, ready to take my second victory in this return out of 3 races. Though it's not my first victory or second victory in NASCAR 15, I won a few races before, but it doesn't matter. Cue the victory theme. I win at Kansas. Another P1 second win in a row over Tony Stewart, Ricky Stenhouse, Clint Boyer. Look where your favorite driver came in. Michael McDowell with a fantastic 10th place. Harvick in his return to this series is 14th. And as we go down through the rest of the field, Larson in 29th. Busch in 32nd, several cars 2 laps behind the race, 3 laps down in some cases, with Michael Annette rounding out the field. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember, if you did enjoy this video, hit a like on it and a subscribe. I think for the time being, I'm bringing back NASCAR 15 full-time on Wednesday. On Wednesday nights. So thank you guys again so much for watching this. This has been David Land on YouTube, a victor at Kansas, and we'll see you in the next video.